All right, hello everyone. Welcome to this installment of Chrome Apps Office Hours here on Google Developers Live. I'm Joe Marini. I am the lead developer advocate here on the Chrome Apps team, and today we're going to be talking about inter-app messaging using Chrome apps and extensions. So before I get started, if you have any questions about what I'm about to show you today, you can of course feel free to shout them at your screen, but if you want the question to actually be answered, you should probably post it on our Google Developers G+ channel or leave it in the YouTube comments, and we will try to get to as many questions as we can. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to show you a demo before I actually jump into some code. So here I've got my Chrome browser running. I'm going to go ahead and open up a new tab, and I'm going to start up a couple of sample apps that I've built. And actually, before I do that, if you want to follow along with me, you're more than free to do so. Jump on over to our GitHub repo. If you go to the Google Chrome / Chrome App Samples repo here on Git, and you scroll on down, you'll see this guy right here, Messaging. That's the sample app that I'm going to be using today. So you can go ahead and fire up the code and play along with me at home if you like. All right, so back to the sample apps. I'm going to scroll down. Now, I've loaded these as unpacked apps. So these are not installed from the Chrome Web Store. I've just loaded them unpacked. So I'm going to start up messaging app number one, and that's this guy right here. And I'll just move him over so we can fit both of them on the screen. So scale it down just a little, and now I'll open up the second one, and that's messaging app number two right here. Okay, so now I've got two applications open. So what I'm going to do now is show these two apps communicating with each other by sending messages to one another. And the scenario here is that you've got one or more Chrome apps that want to communicate with each other. And you can do that by sending messages. And this also works for extensions. There's a pretty common use case. I've seen questions like this on the forum or talks I've given where people say, hey, you know, I've got an extension building a Chrome app. It would be nice if they could communicate with each other. And that's what this feature allows you to do. Now, just to be clear, this is not the same thing as opening a channel from an extension into a content script in the web page. The concept is the same, but the API is slightly different. This is about sending self-contained individual messages from extensions to apps, or apps to extensions, or apps to apps. It's not about opening a long-lived socket-ish port kind of connection so that things can communicate. So okay, with that out of the way, let me show you the demo. So back over here in app one, you can see that it's telling me what its app ID is. This is an important part of the process. I have to have the ID so that I know which app I'm going to be communicating with and from. So I'm going to copy that ID. And over here, I'm going to paste that ID into this field here. And then I'm going to put a little message in there. I'm going to say, hello, app. And I'm going to click the send button. And you can see over here in the first app, I got my message, and it says, from this ID, I got the message hello app. And in the sending application, it says that I sent the message and I got a response back. And the response is just some JSON object saying, hey, the result was okay, we got your message. And now that I've got that connection open, I can go ahead and copy this ID, put it in over here, say thanks for the message, and click send. And you can see that I'm sending messages to and from each application. And just to show you that it works with extensions as well, I'm going to go over here and move this out of the way. And in my Chrome browser, I've installed the sample extension that comes along with this code sample. And you can see that the UI pretty much looks the same. Clearly, I'm an engineer, not a designer, so let's just, you know, put that aside for the moment. But let's go ahead and send a message from the extension to the app. So you can see here I've got my extension ID, and we'll use that in a second when we send the message to the extension. But for the current example, let's go back to messaging app one, or messaging app two, I guess. I'm going to copy this ID. I'm going to go to the extension, paste the ID in, and send it a message saying, hello from the extension. I'll click send. And you can see that it's acknowledging that the message was sent. I got a response back saying, result, okay, got your message. Well, let's see if it actually did. Let's go to app two. And you can see right here it says, from this ID, hello from the extension. Okay, so now let's send a message to the extension. So let's go back to the browser. I'm going to bring the extension up. I'm going to copy its ID. And I'm going to go back to the app. And this time I'll paste the ID in here. And the message I'll send is, hello, extension from the app. And I'll click send. Now, in this particular case, I've implemented the sample to show a notification that's going to pop up in the upper corner of my screen. So pay attention. I'm going to click send. And you can see that I've got a little notification popping up there. That's the extension acknowledging that it got the message and using the notifications API to display the message. All right, so this all looks fine and great. Let's jump over to the code to see how it actually works. And actually, before I jump to the code, let me show you really quickly the API that we're going to be talking about today. So in the documentation for Chrome apps, if you go to developer.chrome.com/apps, and I'm going to scroll on down to the Chrome JavaScript APIs link right here, click on that. I'm going to scroll on down to runtime, click on runtime. So this is the namespace we'll be using. And we're going to be using the SendMessage method right here, and we'll also be using the OnMessageExternal event. So let me jump on down to the SendMessage API. Okay, and you can see that the SendMessage API is pretty simple. It takes an extension ID, or well, an app ID as well, and that's optional. If you don't provide that, then the message will simply go to the origin of whatever the message was, which can be useful if you want to just send messages to yourself. That's fine as well. But that's where you provide the string that represents the ID of the target of the message. The message here is the second parameter, and that can be pretty much anything. It has to be a JSONifiable object, and that's usually what it is, and that's the demo I'll be showing you. And then there's an optional response callback. So if you want to get a response from the target of the message, you can fill in this callback function, and it will be called when the receiver of the message calls a corresponding function saying, hey, I got the message, and everything seems to be fine. All right, so I'm going to jump over to Sublime. And this is the sample. You can see I've opened the folder up here in Sublime. So let's take a quick tour of the source code. So in app one, and the code for app one and app two are pretty much the same. So I'll just go through one of these. You can see that here's the HTML for the UI, pretty straightforward. If we look in the manifest file, you'll notice that there are no special permissions needed to take advantage of this feature. You can just send messages all you want. Don't have to specify any particular permission for your app to be able to do this. In the main JS file, pretty simple. Once again, we've got a launched listener for when our app launches, sets up the main app window. All the magic happens here in the index.js file for the application. So let me scroll down so you can see the code. So in the UI, I have a send button. And on the send button, I'm setting up an event listener right here to listen for the click. And inside the click handler, all I need to do is call chrome.runtime.sendMessage. And you can see that I've got that edit field for where the ID was entered. And so I get the value of that field. That's the ID of the target. And then here's the JSON object that I'm using to send the message. So in this case, I have a property called myCustomMessage. And whatever the value of the text field was, I can make this as complex as I like. And then I've got a function here for handling the response. And all that's doing is just calling some function I wrote to stick some HTML into that div that you see there on the page. And that's pretty much how you send the message. So you have to know the person you're sending the message to, you have the message you want to send, and then the optional response. We scroll down a little bit more. Okay, here's how the message gets handled when it comes in. So again, on the runtime namespace, I have the onMessageExternal event, and I'm just adding a listener to that event. And the handler function for this event does a couple of checks. First, I've got a variable here called blacklisted IDs. So if you have a set of sources that you know you don't want to receive messages from, or on the other hand, if you want to just have a list of known targets that you want to receive messages from, you can set that up in advance and check to see if the ID of the incoming message is only one that you want to handle. So this code is just saying, hey, is the sender ID inside this list of blacklisted IDs? And I could flip this around. I could do it so that it's only inside a whitelisted set of IDs. then I send a response saying, hey, sorry, couldn't process the message, you know, go bug somebody else. Otherwise, I check to see if the incoming request has a property called my custom message. So that way I know that the message is in a format that I know how to handle. And if it is, then all I'm doing here is calling some code that just puts some information inside that result area that shows the sender ID and the value of the custom message. And then I send back a response saying, hey, you know, the result is I got your message. And you can see that the message I'm sending back is a JSON object. And again, this is optional. This will be sent back to the caller when the message receiving is completed. Otherwise, if the request coming in doesn't have the my custom message property, then I say, no idea what you're talking about. Sorry, you must think I'm somebody else. So the handler function takes in the request. It tells me who the sender was, and I've got this little callback function right here called sendResponse. And then sendResponse is just the function that sends the response back to the caller. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the extension code. And what you'll notice is that the extension code is pretty much the same. The difference here is that, well, actually, there's not much of a difference. It's basically calling the same sendMessage function that the app uses. So the API is the same. The only real difference is that inside the event page that I have for my extension, I'm using the WebKit Notifications API to create a desktop notification indicating that I received the incoming message. And so I've got the same handler right here on the runtime namespace. So add event listener on message external. And now I have a way to communicate messages both to and from apps as well as extensions. Not terrible rocket science, pretty straightforward, really easy way for your apps and extensions to communicate with each other. Just one API that you need to know for sending messages, just one event handler that you need to know about for receiving messages, and it's pretty straightforward. So I think if we have any questions, we can take them now. Otherwise, I will see you again on our next installment of Chrome Apps Office Hours. Please feel free to hit us up on our Google Plus G Plus channel if you have any questions. If you think of any after the show is over, I monitor the channel all the time, or you can hit me up personally, Joe Marini, also on G Plus, and I will see you online. Thanks very much for joining me. Hope you enjoyed this installment. Now go out and build some connected apps.